Roger Sinclair had just confessed to sexually abusing a developmentally disabled young man when he dropped another bombshell. That years earlier, as a priest back in Pennsylvania, he had molested multiple young boys.
I did have the same types of touching experiences with others.
Okay.
When the case arrived on his desk, Prosecutor John Hummel was disappointed and he was angry.
This young man who was, horrific things happened to him, and I am not shy about putting that at the feet of the church.
The Associated Press has tracked about 1,700 priests and other clergy members identified by the Roman Catholic Church as having been credibly accused of child sexual abuse, but who are living with little to no oversight from religious or civil authorities. For many years, Sinclair was one of them.
They are they're a tinderbox. They are dangerous.
Decades after the first wave of the church abuse scandal roiled U.S. dioceses, the AP investigation has found suspect priests, deacons, monks, and laypeople teaching school, fostering children, even counseling sexual assault victims. Abuse survivor David Clossy was appalled but not surprised at the AP's findings.
They recruit, educate, ordain, hire, train, transfer, and shield predator priests. But once the heat gets too much, they cut them loose.
The AP review found dozens of these former church workers have since committed crimes, including sexual assault and possession of child pornography. More than 170 continued working or volunteering in churches. Another roughly 190 held professional licenses to work in education, medicine, social work, and counseling. Like the majority of those credibly accused, Sinclair was never criminally prosecuted in Pennsylvania, so nothing showed up on background checks. Allegations against Sinclair date back to his time in the Greensburg Diocese near Pittsburgh. In 1981, two mothers wrote to the bishop saying that the priest had molested their 14-year-old sons, according to the sweeping Pennsylvania grand jury report. The church sent Sinclair for treatment, then returned him to ministry. He was finally removed from the priesthood in 2002. The diocese did not tell the public that Sinclair had been accused of abuse until it released its list in 2018. A spokesman declined to comment on his case. But more than a year before that list was published, Sinclair was working in Oregon when he was seen touching the disabled young man. It was reported to one of Sinclair's supervisors.
He looked out a window and then saw Roger Sinclair with his hand down the young adult's shorts.
Sinclair confessed to the allegation, then divulged his past as a priest.
Okay. How young do you think?
Too young.
Okay. Like under
18.
Okay. How far under 18?
Oh, I guess as much as 4 years.
Binstock was surprised to suddenly find himself in the middle of a national scandal.
Back when he first started offending, if that would have been reported, investigated, and adjudicated, then this case would have never happened.
Sinclair, now 71, is serving 7 years in prison. He wrote a note to his victim saying, quote, "I don't know what else to say except I'm sorry." As for Sinclair's other alleged victims, officials say it's probably too late to hold him accountable. Alan Breed, Associated Press.